again in the lab, da da da. How are you? I want to make a very special video today about a very special item from my collection. It's another one of my collectible light bulbs. I've done videos about my Shelby and also some other of my collectible 19th century bulbs. This is a 20th century bulb, but it's no less significant because this is one of the very first tungsten light bulbs. It is a General Electric Mazda bulb. This one is new old stock, comes with the packaging. It was made in 1915, and the Mazda was first introduced in 1912. It was revolutionary in that the Mazda was the first completely metallic filament bulb, not carbonized the previous versions. Unlike modern tungsten bulbs, the filament is not coiled. It is a very long single wire filament, and I'm eager to fire it up for you and to show what it looks like. Let's take a look close up. All right, here we go. This is the bulb close up. Came in the original packaging. So here's the original patent, February 1912, May 18th, 1915. And the lamp contained herein is a manufactured National Lamp Works of General Electric Company, which sells it under its Mazda and GEM lamps exclusively through its own branches and agents, yada yada. Lamps are sold to central lighting stations. So there you go. It's got a beautiful little nipple on the top, and it's got the badge here. Banner, Mazda, yeah, genuine. And 40 watts, 115 volts. And we can see the glorious filament in there, gossamer tungsten filament held in those cradles in there. You can see that. It's a very long filament. And beautiful, beautiful. Oh, and I got an etching here. General Electric. Oh, I see it's upside down. It says National Mazda, and it's got the GE logo on it. It's etched in the glass there. All right. So, fortunately, it's got a standard Edison base, so it'll go into a modern receptacle. This is the marvelous thing about standards. We really just don't appreciate how standardization changed the world. You know, here I have a bulb from 1915. Fits perfectly into a socket that I bought last year because of standards. It's people have to appreciate that. All right, okie dokie. So I've got my Variac set up, and so we're going to take it easy with this and very slowly turn up the voltage. Oh, it's coming on really fast. So, okay, I guess 20 volts. It's come on. So now with my carbon filament bulbs, I couldn't get them to light up until we got to around 60 volts or so. But that came on right away. So again, this is the difference with tungsten. It starts to incandesce almost right away with, you know, the smallest amount of current. Oh, look at that. So it's 30 volts. Oh, gorgeous. Oh, look at that filament. Yeah. Ah, oh, that is a thing of beauty. Oh, that is just so lovely. Ah. Oh. All right, let's go to 40 volts. Okay, so that's kind of like a cream yellow at 40 volts. 50. This is a beautiful bulb. That is just such a pleasing, pleasing color. Okay, 60 volts, so about half voltage, about 50%. I really don't want to go to full brightness again with something this old. But yeah, that's just so gorgeous. Oh, look at that filament. Oh. Whew. That is just beautiful. All right. Well, there you go. 106-year-old light bulb glowing beautifully. All right. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to all of my patrons down on the Patreon. Thank you for making all these videos possible. I'm Fran. I'll be back here in the lab. Maybe not with something this rare and exciting, but you never know. You never, ever know what's going to be on the bench.
Berserk in my lab. It's where I work. What you're watching. Fran Lab. It's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again.